Open up this conversation. Sanjay Kapoor joining us on the telecast. Ambassador Basmati Mukherjee is with us also. Major Mohammad Ali Shah on the broadcast is also.
And really
okay.
stupid.
Major Mohammad Ali Shah, you know, in the middle of the scrutiny that Bollywood is being put under, the sudden love that the Pakistani establishment is feeling, that they want to create museums for Dilip Kumar, for Raj Kapoor, spend money to buy the houses, which of course are in a completely dilapidated condition. I mean, it smacks of petty opportunism. Where do they think this will take them?
They are just, as Ambassador Mukherjee rightly, very correctly pointed out, they're just being naive and stupid. Rishabh, if you remember, in August 2007, Dina Wadia, the daughter of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, had moved the Bombay High Court, saying being the sole heir, she should be given the possession.
Yeah, of Jinnah House. Yeah.
And whereas Pakistan was claiming, no, it's theirs. Similarly, now they can't have the cake and eat it too. They are being really silly and stupid. Their high hopes. On one hand, they are being hypocrites. They are saying that, oh, they have banned Indian.
But Major Shah, let's boil it down now. What do they want? Okay. Why, at the same time, when, you know, members of the Kapoor family, okay, descendants are being questioned, or will likely to be questioned by the NCB, they want members of the Kapoor family thanking Imran Khan, but they know that's not going to happen. Unfortunately, they have not calculated that here Bollywood celebrities are not that stupid either, that they're going to write a message and thanks to the Pakistani government for buying Raj Kapoor's house and preserving it, which is something that they should have done already. But you can clearly see the game that is being played. They want one person to do a tweet from Bollywood, okay, what a great job Imran Khan has done by preserving the house of Dilip Kumar, right? And they know this will create a controversy here in India. It's so palpably obvious. Now, how do we get people here to see this as clearly as well?
You said it bang on, Rishabh. In fact, you snatched words from my mouth. And the how do we get to see people to get to see it is by the way of spreading awareness like the way you are doing right now. I'm sure people listening to us, they know. They are not to get fooled. What's Pakistan trying to do? They're doing exactly the similar lines what China is doing, psychological warfare. Playing with people's minds, playing with their emotions, they feel by playing this game, they will have their advantage, but they will not have. Because I think our countrymen are smart enough, they're intelligent enough to realize and see through what Pakistan
okay.
is trying to
okay.
ask.
Let me get... Okay, Major Mohammad Ishalem wants to make an interjection. Go ahead, then I have a question. Major, go ahead.
I'm sure both Ambassador Mukherjee and Ms. Sanjay Kapoor would agree with me that when I say that they should give the ownership to the Indian Foreign Ministry and to develop and preserve it as an Indian heritage as we deem fit. We should conserve it. We should have a right over it.
That was going to be my next question. Major Shah. Should we now claim the heritage that we will help preserve these two houses? One, I think, is in Peshawar. And it's not about the money. It's about a subcontinental legacy. Should we also go claim it, Major?
Absolutely. I think there's no hope in hell that they are going to be gracious enough to hand over to us, but certainly we should claim it. And it is, we have a right over that, 100%. And you know what? The litigation about Jinnah's house by the chairman of the Wadia Group is still going on, by the way. Her son, Nusli Neville Wadia, is still fighting the litigation, and that goes on.
Let's close the case. Well, there is something called an Enemies Properties Act. Is Major Mohammad Ali Shah, in the merit of this, the lessons learned, and I mentioned here, you had David Coleman Headley scouting Bombay, happened to be hanging out with a person who comes from a Bollywood family. We all know what happened with Sanjay Dutt, inadvertently or otherwise. We know what Abu Salim was up to within Bollywood as a front man. As Ambassador Mukherjee pointed out, he was a bit player. There were bigger players who were using Bollywood either for money laundering, because they had a fascination for it, who knows. But now, decoupling this as an exercise, what are the lessons learned from 93 onwards?
Rishabh, fortunately, we have learned from mistakes, and you know, I would rather say that. Because, you know, we talk about drugs. Now, we have cracked the whip on drug peddlers. We made a start from somewhere at least. A lot of people would, there's a bowl of contention that they should be, why not Rishikesh, why not you catch other people as well. It's not about water watery. At least start the work. At least we took an initiative and started from somewhere. And why only, like there is a film that which I had done in which on terrorism which is not released as yet, in which there was a line, why only Ajmal Kasab? Every single person whose son and daughter goes rave party and buys drugs contributes to the entire terrorism menace. That is ultimately the root comes from Pakistan. You talk about counterfeit notes. Just a few days back on your channel, we had this program of money laundering. Now it all comes from Pakistan. In the year 2006, I personally was posted in Nagaland in the army with Assam rifles, and we caught a lady with 10 lakh rupees of counterfeit notes, which had, when we interrogated her, the whole origin came from where? Imagine in Northeast India, it came from Pakistan. So basically, ultimately, we are getting smart and alert, yes, and slowly and gradually, we are tightening the noose on people, on culprits, who are directly or indirectly responsible.